When I draw a rectangle, it doesn't show a color, and it doesn't have a stroke. I have set this in the preferences as default, because for colored rectangles, I almost never use a stroke. If you want to change the fill and stroke behavior for just the open document, you can change this in document setup. But if you want to change it for all future documents, you do this in preferences. In the preferences, click on item tools. Then click on the shapes tab. I have set both fill color and line color to none. So when I drag a rectangle, I can give it a color, but there will be no stroke. If I want a stroke, I click on stroke, and give the stroke a color. If I want the stroke to be wider, I click on the line tab. Here I can increase the line width. An image can also be given a stroke. I drag an image frame, and place an image. I can give the image a border, and make the border larger. The border expands however both ways, outside and inside. This means the border hides part of the image. Let's create a border that doesn't hide the image. I set stroke to none. I copy and paste the image, by pressing Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V. I select both objects, right-click, and choose, Group. Now I open the outline panel. I click on the group, and deselect group clip's contents. I open the group, and select the bottom object. I reapply the stroke. We see, that when I now adjust the line width, the border expands only outside the image. Let's give the stroke another color. In the next lecture, we will give the photo a shadow, and a transparent pushpin.